So now we know the bombs were real, but how do we stop the next guy like this if we don't address the toxic atmosphere that has to bear some responsibility for the extreme behavior that's out there? First, leaders on the left, fill the void. If the party in power wants to play mute or continue the hate parade, show you can be better. And you in the GOP, if you want to step up, do it. Call out Trump for what he says. Show you can work with the other side. And as for leadership from the top, prayers continue to go unanswered. First came the easy question for the president. Would he own that it was one of his fans and dissuade others from doing the same? Turns out, not such an easy question.
I heard he was a person that preferred me over others.
Preferred you over others? You were his one and only love, Mr. President. Here he is at the rallies. Here's his Twitter feed. His family and co-workers say he was all about Trumpy toxic positions. Here's the van. And if there were any question as to whether Trump were ducking the obvious here, listen to this.
I did not see my face on the van.
Did you see the van? How could you miss this? Show a picture. And this. I'll keep saying it. And this. He's all over the van. He is the van. The only way he could miss himself is if he looked at the van with his eyes closed. So it's crystal clear that the president has certainly closed his eyes to the reality of what he's doing and what it means to others. More proof. Here's his response about the bombs that targeted the same people that he does.
There's no blame. There's no anything. If you look at what happened to Steve Scalise, that was from a supporter of a different party. You look at what happened to numerous of these incidents, they were supporters of others.
Point by point, there is blame. The toxic talk feeds the fire of guys like this bomber. Less of that, less of this. Let's look at Scalise. Now, with the bombings, you want the guy who did it dismissed as a wacko, so there should be no tie to you. But the man who shot Scalise should be tied to Bernie Sanders, even though that shooter sizes up very similarly to the profile of a deranged man, as does the bomber. Hypocritical. But the bigger point is Trump does not size up well against Bernie in this situation. Bernie never told his supporters to treat opponents as the enemy, and that it was okay to see them as bad people, as evil, and constantly bathing them in talk of violence as righteous retribution the way the president does. And the best proof came just tonight. After the arrest of one of his base, and his saying that America must unify and that he had taken down his tone, he had not a word about his role in all of this, not a word about what he would do to help unify. And as for taking down his tone,
the media has a major role to play, whether they want to or not.
Bashes us, says nothing about himself. They chant CNN sucks, he says nothing. Just after, just the same way as after the Saudis killed the journalist, Trump says, oh, it's wrong to do that. Then he praises that guy Gianforte as his guy, bragging about how he body slammed a journalist. Now tonight, he says we need to stop the negative rhetoric and that he's taken it down. Then he pauses to listen to the nasty CNN chant. He says nothing except to blame us. And why? Because we expose the false and hateful rhetoric that he spews too often, and that will never stop. So a few obvious points. Trump won't change. Why? He wants praise, and the crowd roars when they hear him say this. But, Mr. President, what does it tell you? That you can't get even half the country behind you, despite a robust economy. Maybe if you can show people that you can be better for them, you may do better with them.